Most people in life are familiar with the rules of America, the social constructs, and the social nuance of people who interact with one another in particular communities and particular specific demographics. If you're someone that comes from an affluent and influential community, meaning it's full of people with affluence and influence, you have a different type of social network. You also have a different type of social skill set. If you're coming from an impoverished community, you might not have the best use of the American language. You might make a lot of grammatical mistakes because the people around you, surrounding you, do that. If you're trying to move yourself out of poverty, then you could take the storyline from the Working Girl movie and apply it to your life. How can you take your interests and your ideology and your ideas and move yourself into a better job without harming anyone? Because that was basically the premise of the film, that she wasn't harming anyone. She wasn't intentionally lying either. It just sort of happened to her. But here's the truth. People above her were trying to abuse her. And people above her were her employer. And people above her really got to know her not at all. So in this lifetime, we have to ask ourselves, who do we know? Because it's who we know and who we don't know that are impacting whether or not and how far we go. How far we go in life is not because some super rich dude keeps playing us and our kids with $5. What he's trying to do is pay into you in order for whoring you. But what I can say to you is that a true man of God, a true person who's on God's path, does not harm other people. A true spirit of the Lord's house does not violate the law, lie, steal, and cheat people out of their paperwork, their property, or their privacy.